episode is the episode of the Warped Reporters entitled
Katie Holmes Audits Tom Cruise.
Yes.
Sucks for you, dude.
It does. We all knew this was coming. Now, how did we get here, Katie? How did we get here, Tom? This is how we got here.
All right.
If anybody out there in YouTube world or otherwise thinks that this relationship would last, well, you all knew it wouldn't.
Yeah.
The reason why is because of Tom Cruise, not so much Katie. Katie has to be a little squirrely.
Yep.
Katie must be a little squirrely to begin with, in order for her, you know, for her to spend as much time as she did. And the cigarette baby and all that, but the thing about it is that Tom Cruise is a Scientologist, and I happen to know a little bit about Scientology because we did our research.
Yeah.
So that I knew a bit about it before anyway. And I've said I wasn't going to say this, but I'm going to say it. One of the things that really was a great tutorial for me in learning about Scientology was an episode of South Park, which was like a documentary about it, but that's not entirely where I got my knowledge or where Ben got his knowledge of Scientology. We researched this, so we know what it is. Now, we're going to give you a quick breakdown of what Scientology is, and then we're going to go back to Katie Holmes and Tom Cruise. First of all, this is what Scientologists believe. Take a deep breath now. Alright, 15 million years ago, a giant alien named Gothor came to Earth with a slave spaceship full of tens of thousands of aliens who looked just like us, human-looking aliens. And he enslaved them, made them do things and work on Earth. But there were no humans proper in the world at that time, 15 million years ago. There were primates. There were
Neanderthals.
Neanderthals and hominids. Not even Neanderthals, but there were hominids. Okay, 15 million years ago. This is what they believe now. And Gothor, the giant alien with his giant alien race, enslaved these human-like creatures and then decided they were too much trouble and killed them all. Yeah. Do you know how he killed
them? He tossed them all in live volcanoes.
And alive, burning volcanoes 15 million years ago. He threw their physical bodies into volcanoes. They were incinerated. But, this is the catch, this is what Tom Cruise believes, is that their souls wandered the Earth aimlessly after their incineration by Gothor, the giant alien from outer space. And they eventually attached themselves to the early humans, the hominids, and they inhabited our bodies and possessed us. So many of these ancient aliens exist within us. This is what Scientologists believe. And so Tom Cruise and others and many wealthy Hollywood stars, for some reason this is popular among Hollywood people, believe that the only way to get rid of these slave aliens, who are innocent aliens, by the way, they were the victims of the mighty evil Gothor, who is sort of the Scientology god, okay?
But
he's
same,
an evil god.
At the same time, he's kind of the Scientology devil.
Devil, yeah, so he's a devil god, right? Okay, but
how does that
do
work?
They worship him? No. Do they love him? No. Do they hate him? No. So what they hate is being inhabited by these slave aliens that were incinerated. They used to be human, like us, flesh and blood, right? They used to be like us, but they were thrown into volcanoes, so they inhabited us. And so in order to get rid of them, you have to go to an auditor, which is kind of like a priest. But, you know, I have a Catholic background. Ben is a Mormon, and they're weird, you know, so are we, apparently. But this is real weird. So the auditor is like, kind of like a priest, you know, where you give confession to the priest, you know, I've done wrong, well, forgive me, Father, do 77 Hail Marys, you know, and all that. Hail Mary. But instead, you pay $100,000 a year, roughly. Tom Cruise is given hundreds of thousands of dollars to audit the innocent slave alien spirits from him. Now, what happens to the innocent slave alien spirits that are thrown out of Tom Cruise's body?
Banished from existence.
In other words, they're annihilated. They're once more incinerated. So the slave aliens, the victims of Gothor, are also the victims of guess who?
Us.
No.
Others.
Tom Cruise. Yes. Tom Cruise claims that he has been audited so thoroughly that he has reached the state of clear. Now, in Scientology, the state of clear means that he has expulged all of the slave alien spirits from his body, from his spirit, from his mind, mostly the brain. They believe that they have the gray matter of the brain and the spirits do. Anyway, he's audited, so he's reached the state of clear, which means that he's killed off God knows how many thousands of innocent alien slave babies that were thrown first incinerated by Gothor, the evil emperor god, and then by Tom Cruise. So is Tom Cruise Gothor?
Sounds like it.
Sounds like Tom Cruise is kind of Gothor. Now, don't get me wrong, and I've said this to Ben when we said it off screen, I think Tom Cruise is a brilliant actor. You ever seen The Last Samurai?
Yep.
One of my favorite movie of all time, Stanley Kubrick's final masterpiece, Eyes Wide Shut. And Vanilla Sky, a bunch of other movies where he really is a great actor, but he's completely mad. Now, Katie Holmes, I think, finally realized that she's living with a madman. She's living with a lunatic, you know? I mean, Ben and I, we're the war reporters, you know? Kentucky Madness, you know? We're back from the asylum, yeah. But this guy's the real bloody thing. Now, yeah, true. Now, the thing is, this episode of the War Reporters is about Katie Holmes and Tom Cruise. Katie, you did the right thing, babe. You got away from the freaking lunatic. Now get your kid away from that lunatic. He may be a great actor and all, but he's mad as hell. He's mad as a bloody hatter, alright?
He may be rich as hell too, but hey, you can use that to your advantage.
Yeah,
honey.
You're rich too. You're a great big movie star. Katie, come on, Katie. Nice move, Katie.
Amen.
I think, yeah. Tom Cruise, I feel sorry for you, mate. I do.
Yeah, she's a cute one.
Yeah, she's cute too.
You
know,
you should have converted to keep her.
Yeah, you should have converted to her religion. I think she was a Presbyterian. That would have been nice. Then you could have been more normal instead of the Gothor and the alien. Anyway, that's what Scientologists really believe. Now, if you want me to, if I had more time than the 15 minutes YouTube gives me, which is probably about done now, I could tell you even weirder stuff about Scientology. Anybody that wants to know more about Scientology, contact me, Kentucky Madness 2 channel, via the Warped Reporters, and if anybody's interested, we'll do another episode about it, where I'll give you more details about what Scientology is about. And if anybody that thinks that I'm wrong, especially Scientologists out there, tell me I'm not wrong, because that's true. And no, I didn't get it all from an episode of South Park, but that sparked my interest many years ago, and I researched it, and that's really what you all believe. And I'm talking directly to the Scientologists out there. Apparently they can kill me for this, because you guys are on airplanes, and they don't let airplanes fly over their big compounds, and they're all, are you like, people like, heavily armed? I mean, what's wrong with you? You people are mental.
Sounds about like the law Obama made when he got into office. If you don't agree with him, you're a racist.
Well, I don't know how that applies, Ben, but that's just your opinion. I'm talking about Scientology, Tom Cruise, and Katie Holmes. Let's not get off base here. Now, anyway, I'm going to end this right here. And, Ben, if you've got anything else to say about Scientology, Katie Holmes, Katie, go, girl. Good for you. Get away from it. Run, Katie. Run, Katie, run. Run, Katie, run.
Strap that baby to your back and run.
Strap the baby to your back, put it in a papoose or something, and get the hell away from that lunatic. All right. Anyway, that will conclude today's episode of The Warped Reporters. Thank you for watching, and every day we've got a new episode of The Warped Reporters. Also, one thing we want to mention, Ben, is that we've got two new programs, because I hate the word show, I was going to say shows. We've got two new programs coming out in the next couple of weeks. One is called, which is Ben's own show, where I'll be videographing you doing your own show.
I pretty much just ramble on about random issues.
Alright, and what is the name of your program?
Ben's Deranged Rants.
Right, and I will also have my own program, and my program is called, what's it called again?
William's Weird World.
William's Weird World. And so we're going to have dueling programs and see, you know. But in the end, the Warped Reporters is really only the program that went with Kentucky Madness.
Reporters is kind of our band.
Yeah, if you want to check out what we did before, it's some interesting stuff on there. I mean, it's not bad with Paul McCartney's death or non-death, apparently.
Whatever it is.
Alive. Go check out Kentucky Madness 1 channel, which is, if you watch the first episode.
Link over the head. Link over our heads.
Links, link up there. Kentucky Madness 1, check it. Check it and see. Check it and see. I've got a fever of 103. Yeah. say that all day. I don't know why. So go ahead and check out the Dookie Badges one. It'll give you a little bit of background on us. And thanks for watching, and cheers and peace.
Later.
Word of the mother.